Hey everybody, this is Robert with RC Archery. This video is going to be about making sight tapes quickly and accurately. So grab your rangefinders, let's head out to the target, we'll get some marks. Alright, so the first thing we want to do is pick two distances to get our sight marks at. I do 30 and 60. It doesn't really matter if you want to do 20 and 40, 30 and 60, however you want to do that, whatever your skill range and whatever area that you have to work with calls for there. But basically what you're looking for is for them to have gaps in the middle. You want to have them separate and skip yardages in between, because you're going to use that later on to go back and double check your sight tape marks. Be able to adjust everything when you go to pick your tapes and fine tune them. So again, I do my first shots here at 30 yards. I'm going to use those, be able to get a solid mark. You don't have to be 100% absolute perfect on here. You do want to try to make, decent shots. You don't want to be way off or anything like that, but don't spend a whole lot of time trying to get absolutely 100% perfect shots on target. Alright, so once I've got my 30, I'm going to go to 60 and range that, make sure I've got the right spot. I've got a general idea based on an old tape where I need to put my my sight settings here. If you don't, just go ahead and walk it back. Go back to 40 yards, 50, and then go back to 60, and just, that way you're in a general area, you're not missing the target, anything crazy like that's going on. Same thing as before, make some decent shots. I'd say anything 80% or better on your shots, that'll work. You don't want to kill yourself making a lot of meticulous, spot-on, perfect, marks and everything at this point. You don't want to get, 4, 5, 6 marks, either. 2 will suffice, and, anything 80% or better will be, good enough for what we're doing here. Basically just trying to cut out, the gray hairs, cut out the time and the stress and everything on making your sight tapes, and still getting an accurate one. So we'll be able to adjust our tapes later on, and I'll show you how to do that. Be able to get everything spot on for your bow. How you record your marks is going to matter on what you're going to be using, whether it's a sight tape program on a computer or just individual tapes that you get in a package. If you're using a computer program, you're going to want to use the marks on the outside of your sight. So you're going to take the marking that it's at, plus however many clicks it is, and go about it that way. If you're just using sight tapes, pre-made ones, I make 2 marks on there, my 30 and my 60 mark with a pencil, and then I take the sight tapes that are pre-made and I'm just going to match those up to whichever one fits the best on there. Now, the tapes that I'm using are from my Axel Achieve whenever I got it. You can purchase these separately. You can also get tapes just like this from other companies and everything like that. You can go on a Lancaster Archery and find them. That's the easiest way that I found to do it, and it's still very accurate. What I'll do is I'll leave the sticky backing on the actual sight tape itself. I just take Scotch tape, I put over them, and cut around the outside, the to silhouette it and everything, and I just leave a little bit on both ends. Once I have everything lined up, I'll go ahead and just press those down into place, and then take that, put it back on my bow. I'm going to go out to a longer distance to begin with, and I'm going to start from there and I'm going to check my marks. So here's where skipping those distances comes into play. We're actually going to pick a distance in between. So if you did 30 and 60 like what we did before, you go to 40 and 50 and you're going to take your shots. You're able to see where you're hitting. If you're hitting lower than what your sight tape is and you're having to put clicks down, then that lets you know that you've got misaligned sight tapes. So you need to be able to adjust for that. Same thing, what I do is I go out to 80 and I do the same thing with it. So I'm going to take my 80 yard marks, and I know that if I'm hitting too far down and I'm having to move my sight down from the mark that the tape shows, then that means that I need a slower tape. So I need to go, one more down, or maybe 2 more, however, however off it is. That's what I'm going to look at. So I use markings in between, and then I go out to 80, I take both, I see where everything is hitting, I get a pattern off of that, and it lets me know what I need to do from there. So here's a trick that I have. I am very accurate at 50 yards. I know exactly what my groups are gonna look like because I do a lot of practicing there. So what I will do is I'll go to 50, range that, set my sight, whatever the tape says, I'll just use that for now, and then I'm gonna start making shots, and I'm gonna dial my 50 yard in perfect. This is where I'm gonna take some time to really get some good shots in, some good marks in, and then I'm gonna adjust my sight down to where it's set at 50 yards and I have an absolute perfect mark. Now the reason I do this is because when I start changing my tapes, that's gonna be my reference point. So if I need a faster or slower tape, I know my 50 is dead on. I'm gonna take that next tape and I'm gonna set it on my sight, and I'm gonna use that 50 yard mark that I have that I get from shooting here as my reference to be able to put that next tape on. Here's where the trial and error comes in, but it's also quicker doing it this way versus trying to just get dead on perfect, you know, sight marks for two or three or four or five distances. So I'm gonna take my next tape, whether that be a faster or slower tape, whatever I'm needing. I'm gonna line that up spot on with my 50 yard mark that I had before. I'm gonna put that one into place. Then I'm gonna go back outside. You can go back and pick that middle mark again, just like what we were talking about before. In between the 30 and 60 or 20 and 50, whatever you may do, or like what I do, I'm just gonna go back out to 80 yards here, and then I'm gonna shoot again. And then I'm gonna find out if that tape that I changed it to is perfect, or if I'm still high or low. If I'm still high or low, that's fine. I'm gonna go back in, I'm gonna go back to that 50 yard mark that I had that you saw in the last section of the film, and then I'm gonna change my tapes. And then I'm gonna come back out, I'm gonna shoot again, and it's just back and forth that way until I get a sight tape that's spot on perfect for all my marks. Now usually when I do this, I can get it within one or two changes at the most. Because you know, if you make decent shots at the two markings you got at the beginning, then you're gonna be close. You know, you may be one tape off or two tapes off, just depending on your shots or what was going on. But it's a good way to have a reference tool to be able to go back and forth, have it a little bit quicker done, and still get accurate sight tapes that you're actually going to be able to use all the way from 20 yards to 100. I appreciate you watching the video today. I will have some more out for you coming up next week for my Tuesday Tip of the Weeks. Keep an eye out for my vlogs that I'll do each Thursday. Those come out. If you don't follow me on Instagram, definitely do that as well. It's RC Archery. I post some pictures and give kind of, you know, insights into what I'm doing for the week and just different things going on as well. Again, thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you soon.